All right, so I was responding to some recent comments from some of the videos, and kind of inspired this video a little bit. So this is a fun little journey. So before we had the luxury of the Mini LMT, and before we had the TRX 4 MTs, there was kind of a void in the like miniature monster truck market. But if you think back a little bit, this is what used to occupy my time before I got into these. If some of you remember, is going back a little bit, but they came out with this monster truck. It was made by Venom, and it was called the Mini Giant. And there were a few iterations of this this truck, but it had the big monster truck tires, which I loved, but it was like anything else. It was kind of plagued with some issues and some kind of technology quirks. So like it had this crazy steering system on it where the servo used to be up there, and it had like this real sloppy steering, kind of like a clodbuster issue. And it came with a very underpowered motor. So they had so much potential, but it was never perfect, you know. It was always like, you know, you just had to try to get by with them. So this is the first thing that I really dove into when I got into 3D printing years ago or so. So the first thing that I really started getting into on these Mini Giants was trying to correct the steering. So I designed a new steering setup for them and made an axle, steering on axle setup for these. So you can see in there that basically designed a little bracket that mounted to the suspension area, and then I ended up designing some steering links so that way it would all work kind of like the way that it does here. And honestly, that really like changed the game with this truck. So I started really having some fun with it, you know. I'm like, wow, this thing steers really good now, and now it kind of makes sense. So one thing led to another. And then I'm like, all right, I got to get some more power on this truck because it almost gives you like a little Bigfoot niche, you know? So started upgrading more stuff, started, you know, really getting into the CAD software. And then I'm like, all right, next thing is we need bigger motor, you know? So how do we get a bigger motor in there? And there was some like space constraints on these trucks, you know, with trying to get a bigger motor on there because of the way the chassis was designed. So ended up redesigning and making an entire chassis on the 3D printer. So completely designed a whole new chassis for this truck. So I put the new steering system in here that I designed. So I got the servo on axle, and then I made a higher clearance motor area so I could put a larger motor on there. So I put the Fireball in there, and this thing really woke up at that point. And then, you know, I really just kind of went through and redesigned the entire chassis and built a complete new chassis. And then I'm like, well, while I'm at it, why not put four-wheel steering on it? So I went back through, ended up adding a four-wheel steering. So what I ended up with was a pretty neat little monster truck that had really all the features you want of like a little mini clodbuster type deal. So I had four-wheel steering, a larger motor, and I have resolved the steering problem on this truck. And I actually made a little tilted body system, so the body I didn't have to use the pins for, because I really hate body pins. So what I did was the body would actually bolt to the back, and then it would pivot, and then it would lock forward, and then just attach to this this little Velcro piece here. And man, I'm telling you, before these things existed, this was one of those things that I used to fill that niche in that miniature monster truck market. It had the solid axles, which made it handle like the monster trucks, like the way we would want them to be. And then you had the four-wheel steering, and then obviously it was actually decent steering. And then, you know, you put the bigger motor on there. So I ended up buying, I can't even tell you how many of these monster trucks over time. So I bought every one of them that I could find on eBay. And then I just kept going and going with it. So, and then, you know, so I just picked up more and more of them and just really started building them. And this one's got a different setup on it, a little more power, able to run lipos on it now. So this one is just another one. But I just thought that this would be a fun project to kind of share with you, to show you how deep the obsession with the miniature monster trucks kind of went, and how far you can take it when you spend a little time messing around with that 3D printer, and you can really kind of make things your own. So just wanted to put this out there. I thought that the group that's been kind of chatting with me would find this one interesting. But I'll throw some batteries in here and get you guys some running video of this, because this thing's a lot of fun, honestly. It does pretty well, and with the four-wheel steer, and it really acts like a little monster truck. So let me know if you like the content. Give us a shout. Definitely keep the comments coming. I love it. It's kind of digs up a lot of fun stuff, you know. Meet some really interesting people out there, and I think that there's a lot of people that kind of share this type of stuff, this passion with me. So let's keep it going. Let's have some more fun. Let's get some more crazy builds out there. But I'm thinking now I might put a little sensored brushless motor on here, and take this thing back out of off the shelf and put this thing to work again and see how it compares against the new technology that's out there. I always wanna pull for the original stuff, man, because that's kind of the era that I come from. I like pulling for the old solid axle monster trucks. All right, well, let me know what you think, and we'll talk to you on the next one.